baby.
Take three couples who love to entertain.
Make sure you get the fish without the bones.
Ask each pair to throw a dinner party for their rivals.
Who is not going to like it?
I can't even be polite.
And get them to score each other in secret.
15.
Today, lasting impressions.
Calm down, Mr. Bennery.
Normal service will be resumed as soon as possible.
He's somewhat eccentric.
What's the most romantic thing you two have ever done together?
And tricky questions.
Oh, brownie.
You carry on, then.
As each couple competes to win a £1,000 prize.
Michael, for Christ's sake, put that radio down.
Today on Couples Come Dine With Me, we're in Berkshire, home to Britain's top celebrity couple, magician Paul Daniels and the lovely Debbie McGee. Now that's magic! And hoping to conjure up a winning night is the first of today's couples, cultured types, 49-year-old Eveline and 59-year-old Michael.
Seen the ceiling? Arrows of love.
Aww.
We love going to stately homes. That's our life.
And...
Whew, is that all? No, there's more to it than that, isn't there?
Yes, we like to walk through the bluebells, especially at this time of year. Best thing about Michael is that he makes me laugh.
And what is it? This is our 23rd year of seeing bluebells together, isn't it?
I entertain Eveline all my life. That's
he
my...
tries.
He certainly does.
OK, the butter is melted. We have meltdown.
Michael, I've got a whisk. Not yet. Leave the butter till time.
Put that butter down, Michael.
Oh, it's going to be a long 3 days. First up, dessert. Black Cops Gatto, whatever that is.
Like a small Black Forest Gatto, I'd have thought. Because I think Cops is like a small forest.
Oh, he knows his woodland.
Hello, Natasha speaking.
Meet the second of today's couples, 36-year-old businesswoman Natasha and 32-year-old quantity surveyor and history buff, Paul.
Well, since when have I drank black tea?
Been together 5.5 years, six years. We're like chalk and cheese. We're completely polar opposites, I think.
You like potato. I like
Natasha's busy working a lot of the time.
Hi, Periscope, it's Natasha again.
To be honest, I find Paul's interests quite boring, really.
Thank you.
Not a compliment. Back with our first hosts, the chocolate sponge base is ready to bake, so Eveline and Michael move on to the filling.
It's turned into cream cheese, Michael.
You were only supposed to whip it until it was firm.
Thank you, Mr. Kane.
Anything with chocolate buttercream. Oh, sorry, am I drooling already? Then I'm a happy man.
Completing the lineup, Leanne and boyfriend Ricky, who've got a 22-year age gap.
Obviously, I'm the younger one. She's 47, I'm 28.
Yeah, I've aged well.
But
it's the cream.
It's not really a problem for me.
They met at a soul music event.
Ooh.
2 years ago.
We have a lot of fun together. We do quite a lot together. I saw that. You're going down, 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 down.
Oh, the shame. Back in the kitchen.
Beautiful.
The sponge is done. All Michael and Eveline need to do is layer with cream and berries.
Yay!
High five.
You crazy kids. Next, it's on to the starter. Grilled goat's cheese with pecans and cranberry sauce.
I quite like goat's cheese. I'm happy with cheese. I love cheese. That's cool.
So the big problem is that some people... cannot stand goat's cheese.
I can't even be polite to eat goat's cheese. It's the smell. Oh, OK.
Well, good luck explaining that one, then.
1, 2, 3, go.
They start with the less controversial cranberry sauce.
He cut you, then.
By pouring lemon juice over apples to create an infused liquid.
Actually, why am I doing it like this? What an idiot.
It's not that funny.
Oh!
To cranberry jelly, they add olive oil and honey.
Why train a turkey to climb trees when you can hire squirrels?
Yeah, that's a good question.
You're crazy.
He is.
Careful.
Finally, Michael pours in the liquid from the soaked apples and the sauce is done.
And I'll be drizzling that over the toasted goat's cheese, pecans and rocket.
So all that's left is the main. Seared duck breast a la plum with Hasselback potatoes and veg.
I really love savoury with sweet. Really love that. I think they complement each other really well.
I haven't had duck done like this before. I've literally only had it from the Chinese, so it'd be good to try it out.
Eveline and Michael begin by making a plum sauce.
I can't say the word plum without saying it with a Bucks accent. I don't know why not.
I don't know why either. They heat plums and onions with sugar, stock and red wine before scoring the duck breasts. Yes, I said score, not slice.
Oh, it's a bit too far. You're going too far through.
Duck can dry really quickly, and also if it's left to sit for too long, it can dry out even if it's cooked perfectly.
You were only supposed to take the bloody wings off.
And you have already done that blooming impression.
They'll fry the duck later, so it's off to get changed before their guests arrive. First in, it's soul lovers Leanne and Ricky.
My name's Eveline. Lovely
Ricky.
To meet you. Ricky.
Hi, I'm Leanne. Nice
Hi,
to meet
Leanne.
You.
Lovely to meet you.
A little gift for
Looks
you.
Gorgeous, thank you. What I need to do is get you both a drink.
Sounds good to me.
I was going to bring
idea.
You champagne cocktails. Do you both drink?
Yes, we
Fantastic.
Do.
Whoa! Baby.
I'm feeling a bit nervous now.
So are the guests?
Oh, they're called Leanne and Ricky.
Wait a minute. Leanne.
Leanne Ricky. And Ricky.
Ricky, Leanne.
And they seem really nice.
Nice
lovely.
To meet you, Ricky.
They seem really Ricky. Lovely, actually. Champagne cocktails
Ooh,
for you.
Lovely. Thank you very much.
Hi.
This is Michael.
Michael.
Hi.
Ricky.
Ricky, I know. And
yes.
Leanne. Nice to meet you, Michael.
Nice to meet you.
Next to the door, Natasha and Paul.
Hello. Lovely to see you. Welcome.
Nice to meet you.
My name's Eveline. And this is Michael,
Hello, Michael.
My husband.
Paul,
that's right.
Yeah.
Paul.
First impressions of Michael, I'd say probably he's somewhat eccentric.
Welcome, everybody. Leanne, Ricky, Paul, Natasha.
Well done.
Well done on the name.
Well done, Morris. I mean, Michael. Coming up.
Pretending.
Amorous acting.
Hold on.
He's looking at your kid.
Don't do that again.
That's my Casablanca.
And memorable meetings.
So the beer goggles didn't come off.
So we couldn't really remember what each other looked like.
It's a bit of an embarrassing story.
We need to start lying about that.
It's night one in Berkshire, where the first of our three couples, Michael and Eveline, are competing for the £1,000 prize.
Where's the knife?
Oh, calm down, don't panic.
Calm down, Mr. Mennering. Don't panic, Mr. Mennering. They won't even remember that, will they?
No, that's Dad's army.
Dad's
waiting
army.
For it.
Focus, please, Michael. While the hosts get on with their starter, guests Leanne and Ricky have a nosy around upstairs.
Wow.
That's a cool photo.
Is that amateur dramatics?
That looks like Michael.
Yes, that is, isn't it? He's actually quite theatrical. I can see him, actually. I can actually see it.
So do you think that's Eveline, then?
I think it's possible, because if you're going to have a picture of a love scene, in a sense, you wouldn't want it to be with an ex.
All right, Sherlock. Meanwhile, Natasha's still fretting about the goat's cheese starter.
They seem very pleasant.
No, they do. They seem really lovely, and that makes me feel even worse about not liking the goat's cheese.
Well, just try it, then.
I couldn't try it, be sick.
Well, that's good to know. In the kitchen, the dreaded goat's cheese isn't the only thing getting a grilling.
Just watch the goat's cheese now, please, for me. Don't let it burn. Watch it for me. Just watch it.
Yes, boss.
As ordered, grilled goat's cheese with pecans and cranberry sauce.
Here you go. Here's your stuff.
There you go. Yes, ladies first.
Do you help yourself to bread?
Oh, that's a big piece of goat's cheese. Good luck with that, Natasha.
It looks lovely.
Yeah, let's leave the acting to Michael, shall we?
What we were worried about was that some of you wouldn't like goat's cheese.
You've spoken too soon, my love.
Grumbled!
Yes, I think we have.
I am genuinely sorry. It's probably the only thing that I would... Ordinarily, I would try my best and just go through it. But goat cheese, I just couldn't do it.
Our son actually gags when he eats goat cheese, so don't do that.
Oh, but the dressing's fantastic. And
goat cheese was delicious. I didn't want Natasha to try it because I can only imagine what would have happened if she had.
This is really nice. I've never had before. I thought the starter was awesome.
Lovely starter. Yeah, well thought out. Everything blended really well together.
So when we were upstairs, we saw a couple of photographs. Was it you two in the theatre?
No, yes, we're sure it was. We're definitely sure it is you, Michael.
Yeah, we were definitely.
Did it not look like me?
No, because we looked at the love scene.
I was the leading lady and he was the leading man. And we had to fall in love in the play. And then we fell in love in real life.
Oh, that's so lovely.
We had to do a stage kiss. Yeah. We did the kiss over and over and over and over and over.
Cut.
Can you remember the lines?
No, I can remember the kiss, but not the
lines. You can remember the kiss, but not the lines.
That's all right, we'll just do the kiss then.
Yes. Pretending kiss. And then one night.
On the stage.
Hey.
Encore!
So was it like a theatrical kiss then, like on the chink? Yeah, yeah, see, I would have just gone on for the full-on whack. Smackaroonies. Gotta feel it. Gotta be feeling it.
Here's looking at your kid.
Don't do that again.
That's my Casablanca.
Now everyone's an actor.
Yeah, and Ricky, how did you two meet?
We were on a Soul Weekender.
Oh, so, brilliant!
Yeah.
A Soul Weekender. I've always wanted to go to Soul Weekender because I was from the 80s.
We had a party back in our caravan, so our caravan was rocking.
Some strange Soul Week?
You hadn't heard of a Soul Weekender?
Is this something we should try, dear?
I can see him there waving his jacket and his shirt around, giving it large.
How did you two meet?
It was like 1:45 in the morning. I was out on a girls' night, he was out on a boys' night, and
so can I ask you a question? So the beer goggles didn't come off the next day when you saw him?
Well, I couldn't really remember what each other looked like.
I didn't understand it. I was nodding away, but I didn't understand what they meant.
Well, they met in
a nightclub.
And she couldn't remember what he looked like.
It's a bit of an embarrassing story.
We need to start lying about that. But then we made a proper date, a very well-known Rosette Award restaurant, and laid the works on, and I thought, but if this is a sign of times to come.
We've not been back since.
With the starter mostly hitting the spot, Michael gets on with frying the duck.
I said to Michael that my code word, if they're overdone, is you copy me.
Eh?
You know, rubber duck?
No.
Rubber duck, when you had walkie-talkie radio. In the convoys. In the 1980s.
Convoy. No.
We had a great big convoy. You know that?
No.
Yes, here's a rubber duck.
And it's going to be a rubber duck. I'm going to go, you copy me.
What are you talking about?
And that's the code that has been overdone.
Fine, all the best with it.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sorry to announce there's been a little trouble with the duck and there's going to be a slight delay. But normal service will be resumed as soon as possible. Okay?
I thought that was funny.
It was hilarious.
I wasn't actually not expecting that.
I think Michael's great. Could I live with Michael? No.
Better stick with a guy you can't remember meeting. Et voila! See her at the duck breast à la plume with Spuds and Finch.
This looks fantastic.
Smells great. Good. Well, I hope you like it. Tuck in.
I'm excited.
Who cooked the main?
Michael cooked the main.
I was in charge.
The plum sauce is amazing. It's really lovely.
Good.
Delicious.
Yeah, it's really good.
I'm so glad you like it.
I love the plum sauce. I thought it was awesome.
It was cooked pretty much perfectly, to be honest, the duck breast.
The skin was really crispy. I really enjoyed it.
So what are your hobbies and passions, Paul?
Like history.
Do you? Oh.
My favourite.
We like history.
All right, Natasha.
What era are you mostly interested in history?
I quite like the Victorian era.
What's your favourite person from the Victorian era?
Isambard Kingdom
Brunel. Yes, I knew you were going to say that. When he mentioned history, the man.
It was quite nice to be able to talk to others about Brunel, I suppose. If I ever mention that with Natasha, I get a resounding two fingers up pretty instantly.
I don't swear at you, I just don't bother listening.
Oh, well, that's perfectly acceptable.
Natasha, I'm afraid we're going to have to ask you, what is your favourite period in history?
I'm not really interested in history.
Not at all, right.
And that's the history lesson over.
So what are your passions then?
I quite like work. I do a lot of work.
Work every hour you possibly can.
Don't you wish that you could have, like, maybe a little bit of time off?
If I wanted to have a half day, I could if I wanted to. I don't, but I could.
Paul, does Natasha work too much?
I'm getting the look.
Yeah, the look's dangerous.
I would take Paul's at 8 o'clock at night, the time when we sort of relax.
Yeah.
And she makes sure we're not relaxed by making sure she stays in the room, speaks really loudly, and so.
My intentions are that the call is always going to be only a couple of minutes. Unfortunately,
it goes longer.
They go longer.
obviously, Natasha's got a passion for her work. I don't think, like, from tonight, I haven't found what they have got in common.
Well, before Natasha gets a work call, you better serve dessert.
There. Thank you.
Definitely it's a winning dessert. Be very disappointed if this wasn't a winning dessert.
Well, there it is. Black Cops Ghetto.
Is it me, or is there a hint of liqueur in your poudin?
You're quite right, Ricky. Some of it I brought back from holiday, and I thought I'd bring you back a little bit of our holiday in Italy, where we bought this lemon liqueur.
Mm. And if it's all right, we're going to spend the next hour looking through our holiday snacks.
Ooh, taxes!
It was a nice dessert, but not to my particular taste, wasn't blown away by it.
But it was lovely. I can't take the away from it. It was nice. I just think they played it safe.
Scores out of 20, please.
I reckon give ourselves 20 out of 20. Oh, come on. You can't fault what we did tonight.
Wanna bet?
We've had a great night, but the food was more gastro than gourmet.
And for that reason, it's 15.
Thought the hosting was really good tonight.
Really enjoyed the food.
And that's why we're going to give them 15.
I'm sorry, it's just not in my nature to boast. I just can't do it.
Well, your score should give you something to shout about. Michael and Evelyn bagged a respectable 30 out of 40. It's day two in Berkshire, and the turn of soulmates Leanne and Ricky, who are hoping to wow their guests with their shared love of Caribbean cooking. Oh, nice onesie, Ricky.
They probably haven't even tried any of the food that we're going to cook today. It's just something, like, to do with our roots and just want to share it with other people.
And talking of sharing...
I think it was nice for Paul when he found out that we were also interested in history. Yeah. We were well away.
Oh, history, we were well away.
It was quite nice to find someone with, or some people with a shared interest. rather than... taking no interest at all in it.
And for their first taste of the Caribbean, West Indian fish cakes.
We have not had very much West Indian food before.
No. No.
Fish cakes can fall apart if it doesn't bind very well. Hopefully that won't happen.
I don't think I've ever tried West Indian food, so I'm really looking forward to it.
Ricky starts by preparing the salt fish.
Remember, you've got to wash it first. Thoroughly.
Yes, chef.
I'm talking to my granddad on the phone and I'm asking him for some advice on the fish, and then all you can hear is my nan in the background shouting,
make sure you get the fish without the bones, because otherwise it's not cooked properly.
Does everyone do impressions in Berkshire? To make the batter, Leanne blitzes spring onions with peppers, eggs and flour. Oh, yes, shake that funky colander. Once the salt fish is cooked and mashed...
Yeah, let's just get this in here.
It's added to the batter.
Wow, that's fantastic. That's going to sort it out.
Yeah, baby.
Yes.
Ricky and Leanne will fry the fish cakes just before serving, so they move on to their main, curried mutton with rice and peas and homemade coleslaw.
I think it could be a winning dish, for sure. It's tasty. What? I'm sorry, who is not going to like it?
I've not cooked mutton, so I'm guessing it'd be quite tough if it's not cooked slowly.
You see, you can't go wrong with peas. It doesn't matter what you're cooking, as long as there's peas in it, you've got something that tastes nice, haven't you?
Bad luck, Michael.
West Indians are notorious for having things that are called nothing to do with what it actually is. It is actually rice and beans. They aren't peas.
To make the rice and beans, Leanne adds garlic and spring onions to coconut milk, then seasons. Meanwhile, Ricky fries off the marinated mutton.
Now it's time for the secret ingredient, which is the scotch bonnet. This adds the fire. Well, it could blow someone's head off.
I don't like really strong spices.
I can take it spicy.
Do you like strong spices?
Bring on the spices, I think.
This one's not going to be particularly hot.
With a single scotch bonnet completing the course, it's on to dessert. Double chocolate mousse.
Oh. It's chocolate and it's mousse and it's dessert. I'm a massive dessert person. You're not so much, are you?
You two really are like peas in a pod. Or should that be beans?
Dessert for a chocolate lover, I mean, it's double chocolate.
What does it mean? There's two lots of chocolate? Or...
Bingo! It's a combo of white and dark chocolate mousse. And Ricky's giving it all a Caribbean kick.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, double up on that, babe.
With a splash or two of Jamaican rum.
Come on, put more in.
whisk together eggs with melted white chocolate and a little dash of romance.
It can't eat off your nose.
No, you can't eat off my nose. No. God. Ow, that's hot.
Smooth.
That's really hot.
It's my version of the movie Ghost without the Potter's wheel.
Well, wouldn't go that far, babe. He does it all the time. Bless him.
I'm most affectionate. Honey.
You are affectionate. You are affectionate. I'm very lucky.
No. While the old smoothie starts layering the chocolate, Leanne caramelises pecans before spraying them with food colouring.
That's just to give it a bit of sparkle.
And that's just to smash them to smithereens.
I think we've spanked it.
Crikey. Dessert done. Ricky can now get out of that baby grow before they welcome their first guests. And here they are. It's...
Evelyn and Michael.
Michael, good to see you.
Yeah, I'm not going to kiss you tonight.
How are you?
Very well, thank you.
Wow. How are you?
Next, it's Natasha and Paul.
Hey, welcome, welcome to the merry band. Back together again.
Cheers.
For hopefully for another great night. Cheers, everyone.
Kind of diners.
Yeah.
Coming up, unsubtle hints.
He took me to Venice and everything last year, even for Valentine's Day.
I'm sure she had a wonderful time in Venice. I've not been myself.
And awkward accents.
Make sure you're putting the right fish in there.
Me and my wife, we're happy to be here.
I thought that was a fair guy. Cheers.
Cheers.
It's night two in Berkshire, where Leanne and Ricky are hoping to win today's £1,000 prize with their Caribbean-themed menu.
There's a tiny bit of Jamaican rum in there, a very tiny bit.
Yeah.
Whilst the hosts crack on with their starter, Evelyn and Natasha have a snoop around upstairs.
Oh, it's nice. Looks really homely, doesn't it?
Very nice.
Picture. She looks really young without makeup.
They're all plain.
Yeah, but they're her, aren't they? Yeah. They're the real her. I think it means that she's really confident in what she looks like, because there are so many women who aren't happy to see me with no makeup.
Are there? I would be one of them. No, me!
And while the girls chat away...
Victorians, wasn't it?
The boys are bonding downstairs.
The whole Reading is Victorian brick.
Yeah, absolutely.
When things were different.
Absolutely, yeah. They're so pretty and ornate.
Yeah.
You can't beat a bit of brick banter. Back in the kitchen, Leanne is frying off the fish cakes.
It's going all right at the moment.
While Ricky makes the plates pretty.
Yeah.
And they're ready. West Indian fish cakes served with rocket and aioli.
Smells absolutely
lovely. It does, we're out here going, oh, good. That's exciting
never,
stuff.
Never tried Caribbean food, really.
Yes.
Never at all.
I've never tried Caribbean food before either.
Get in.
You enjoyed it?
So I was really excited.
We've got some Caribbean virgins on the table. Get involved, I'm loving it.
Yeah. We're talking actually about preparing these. And somehow I ended up with a dish towel on my head and I was saying,
make sure you're putting the right fish in there. Otherwise it won't cook properly.
The first bit of accent I heard. I need to hear this accent, because I want to hear the...
He wants to practice.
Me and my girlfriend, this thing I feel, is a pleasure. Come back anytime you want,
yeah? Me and my girlfriend.
Thank you.
That's good.
Me and my girlfriend, me and my wife, we're happy to be here.
I thought that was a fair guy.
That was possible.
Okay, now I'm going to tell you.
There's like slash on the Scottish side as well.
And the Irish.
Yeah.
It always tends to go a bit well.
A bit muddled.
Michael, for Christ's sake, put that radio down.
Oh, why, Eamon?
It's absolutely delicious.
I'm glad you like it.
Yeah.
The start was really, really lovely. Brilliant. Really enjoyed it.
Yeah, I thought it was delicious. I thought the spicing of the starter was spot on.
I was worried it was going to be too spicy, but it was perfectly spiced.
Everything about it, great.
So, Leanne, when we were upstairs, we noticed this photo that you had of a montage of different pictures of you.
Those photos, Rick actually did that little montage.
Every one of those pictures, she didn't pose for. They're natural.
I mean, it looked like none of the photos have makeup on. Are they
she
all...
didn't pose for any of them.
So ladylike.
That really shows, though, that you love Leanne whatever she looks like.
Yeah, so that is really sweet.
Candid shots are the best.
He is such a sweetie. He really is.
I would kill you if you did that to me. It just wouldn't happen. I wouldn't even see the funny side of that, to be fair.
Well, okay.
Do I look better with or without makeup?
No different.
Oh, shut up. What does that do? And he comes out just in my makeup look all right.
Lovely.
He wasn't coming across that, all that, what's the word? Convincing. He wasn't all that convincing.
But some people have difficulty expressing themselves.
Yes, they do.
I think he's basically tried to say that it makes no difference the way he feels about you.
I'll tell you, yeah, absolutely. You should stand shoulder to shoulder with this gentleman, because he'll get you out of so much crap.
Well, I think he did throw him a life, to be honest.
Paul
Browning! You said you couldn't tell the difference if I wore makeup or not.
Yeah, but I didn't mean it quite like that, and Ricky hit the nail on the head with what I was trying to get across.
Let's move on for Paul's sake.
I'm really glad you liked it. I'm well chuffed. I think it's come out really well.
I think she's done fantastically.
No, we've done fantastically.
No, you're the best. No, you're the best. We're both the best. With mutual love in the air, it's on to the main.
Rice and peas and chicken and ting. Yeah, buddy.
Yes, indeed. It's curried mutton with rice and peas and homemade slaw.
I hope you like it.
Well, that meat is really
it's
tender.
Delicious.
That meat is really tender.
Good, I'm really glad.
I've never tasted mutton before, and I think I prefer it to lamb. And it wasn't mutton dressed as lamb, it was actually mutton.
Oh, you're pleased with that one, aren't you?
Really enjoyed the main course. The coleslaw went really well with it, which I was really shocked at, because obviously coleslaw we generally eat with salads or jacket potatoes and things like that. I'd never have thought of putting coleslaw and a curry together.
Yes, it's revolutionary. As they tuck in, talk turns to age gaps.
So, how many years is it between the two of you, then?
Just about 9 years.
Oh, so it's not that bad.
No, it's not that big of an age gap.
No, that's not big of an age gap.
No.
Ours is a big age gap.
What's the age gap between you and Ricky?
How many is it?
22.
Yeah, 22.
Are you the young head on older shoulders, or are you?
No, it's definitely young head on older shoulders, definitely.
It is a pretty big age gap, because it's over 20 years, 22 years. That's a whole generation.
I was quite surprised, because he looks really young. Even his mannerisms and energy, he seems a lot younger.
It's really lovely.
You can tell they're very romantic with each other.
He's awesome. He took me to Venice and everything last year, and for Valentine's Day.
Oh. I'm sure she had a wonderful time in Venice. I've not been myself. Subtly.
He's not getting the hint.
Michael surprises me a lot as well.
I think it's awesome.
If we go out for dinner, he never tells me where we're going.
That's lovely.
Every single time I don't know where I'm going to turn up.
It's the least I can do, really. It's not a great effort not to tell you where we're going.
What's the most romantic thing you two have ever done together?
That's Paul.
Paul, what's the most romantic thing you've ever done with Natasha?
You carry on, love.
I bought you flowers quite a few times.
Paul struggled a little bit to come up with an answer, which I thought was a bit of a...
Define romance.
Being spontaneous to show your affection and love to somebody through gifts all weekends away.
So spending money.
Yeah.
Who says romance is dead?
Were we romantic at the beginning, do you think?
Oh, I was. You just beat it out of me.
Are you sure I was there? I was probably at work.
Yeah, that's what it is.
Admitted, at least you admitted.
Thanks.
You are welcome.
We thought it was tasty, yeah. It was good. That's how we normally cook it, so I'm happy with what we produced.
Yeah. Let's see if you can make it a truly memorable night with your pud. Double chocolate mousse.
Sure? What's in the top? Yeah.
It's pecans.
Oh, okay. With golded. Like gold.
Yes. Yeah. I've given them a bit of bling. Bit of gold bling.
Did you put something sweet on them as well?
Caramel.
They're caramelized pecans.
They're delicious.
Chocolate sends up all sorts of indoor
serotonin.
Pheromones. No, dear, I can't get those.
Pheromones, I meant, not ceremonies.
Oh, what a mix-up. Taxis!
Dessert was lovely, although one or two of the layers on mine wasn't completely set, so it was a bit runny.
Dessert was delicious.
It was wonderful. I sort of wish it wasn't quite as big, because I ate the whole thing.
I'm just going to go out there. I'm going to go 18. I'll score us 18.
I'd give us 15.
I'm not with him.
Mm-hmm. There are a couple of minor flaws, so...
We're going to score 15.
Great food, a great evening.
The only thing we could fault was a tiny, tiny bit of the dessert.
We're going to give them a 16.
So Leanne and Ricky's Caribbean-themed evening has edged them into the lead with a totally tropical 31. It's the third and final day in Berkshire. And a chance for Paul and his workaholic partner Natasha to show they have something in common by preparing a meal together in their bid to win the grand.
I can't see it myself how they're going to be as a team. I think there's going to be some sparks.
I think it could possibly go up if Natasha gets stressed.
Feeling a bit pressured.
Are you?
No, you'll pull it off.
I'll pull it off.
Sorry, we'll pull it
Thank
off.
Thank you.
Good luck, team. First up, the starter, seafood millefeuille with anchovy sand and oyster mayonnaise.
OK.
I don't know what...
Millefeuille, millefeuille...
I don't even know if we pronounce that right.
Thousand leaves.
Almost. It's a French food term, which means thousands of layers. No, does it really?
I wanted it to sound posh. I didn't want to say a pile of fish.
No, well, that's understandable. But before stacking all that seafood, they start on the oyster mayonnaise. Oh, good heavens.
I don't want to be negative or anything, but I've had oysters once, and it wasn't a happy experience.
Oh, no. I thought they were supposed to be an aphrodisiac, oysters.
That was the problem.
I think the accent was the problem.
Here we go.
Natasha starts by blitzing the oysters.
It's just gone in my hair. I'm gonna stink a fish.
Paul lends a hand by pouring in vegetable oil.
There you go. Done. I would absolutely prefer to have gone to work than done this today, for sure.
That's the spirit. Next, it's on to the fish.
Say when, then, because I don't know how much to...
Same as what you'd put on your dinner.
Having passed the salmon seasoning test, Paul's promoted to prawn peeler.
Hey, Jack.
Yeah, I'm doing all right, thank you. Anything with limited skill that a chimp could do is given to me, isn't it?
Do you want me to give you something a bit more difficult?
No, thank you. Quite content.
That's it, Paul. Know your limits. The prawns are mixed with crab meat, creme fraiche and lemon juice.
Stir it vigorously.
I don't think I've done anything vigorously in my whole life.
Really?
The alternating layers of fish are then stacked up.
It's OK. Don't touch it.
I'm not.
Starter down, it's on to dessert. Dark chocolate and orange tart.
You could get a soggy bottom on the tart.
Oh, don't encourage him.
You don't want that, do you?
Oh, told you.
Massive chocolate fan. Even bigger dark chocolate fan.
I've got the complicated task of cutting up chocolate into small pieces.
You're not allowed a sharp blade, then. Meanwhile, Natasha's candying orange peel and then covering her sponge base with chopped nuts.
Can you move that, please?
Yep.
Teamwork at its very best. On goes the melted chocolate, which they'll leave to set. Dessert is done, so it's on to the main. Beef Wellington with mushrooms, dauphinoise potatoes and a red wine jus.
What's not to like? Beef, good. Mushrooms, good. Potatoes, good. Red wine, good.
American accent. Yeah. While the meat's being seared, they blend mushrooms for the filling.
Mushrooms.
There's nothing that she hates more.
Oh, no, I hate mushrooms.
Mushrooms.
Don't worry, Natasha's thought of everything.
I'm going to do two without mushroom, just in case somebody doesn't like mushroom.
For the others, they wrap seared beef fillet in prosciutto with the mushrooms.
Make sure it goes down into that middle.
And they're all encased in pastry. These two are really pulling together, and Paul's even being entrusted to crimp the edges.
No, you're making it look rubbish. I'd rather
I've not done it yet. No, I've not done it.
Yeah, but look, it looks rubbish. I think maybe you need a different job. Baking sheet on the tray would be good.
Back to the chimp work.
Food prep done. The organ grinder and her monkey can go and get changed.
Right, it's ours to lose, so you've got to think before you speak.
I know what he's thinking. First guests are here. It's Eveline and Michael.
Evening!
what's this cocktail called?
Kia Royale.
Well,
yes, I haven't had one of these since 1982.
Oh.
Finally, Leanne and Ricky.
Thank you all very much for coming. I hope you have a fantastic evening.
Yeah, looking hopefully forward to it.
Ever the optimist.
Nice start.
He's good at killing conversations. It's fine.
Coming up, money issues.
This is a highly significant collection of coins and it should be around the room.
You're 30-odd years old. You can't put coins on the bloody wall.
And the winning couple is revealed.
I'm really nervous, I don't know why.
It's the third and final night in Berkshire, and it's Paul and Natasha's turn to host in a bid to win the grand.
Make it look nice, yeah.
Try.
Don't have it hanging off, then.
While they crack on with their starter, Ricky and Michael take a look upstairs.
Now, what is that sticking out? Shall we have a little look-see?
Ooh, value. Did you know every head of each monarch goes the other way each time? Because he's facing that way, the one in between will be facing this way. See what I mean? He's facing that way, she's facing that way. Oh, which way will I go when I eventually get there? When Mama finally pops her clogs, I will face that way.
I hate to presume that any time...
Hello, it's a Prince Charles off.
It would be very presumptuous of me to assume that any time soon Mama will abdicate.
It sounds nothing like me.
But why are they here?
He can't be that emancipated that she puts his stuff under the bed.
This is a highly significant collection of coins, and it should be around the room.
Anyone know who that was an impression of? No, me neither. Back in the kitchen, and the starter's ready.
Hopefully everyone will like it, and it'll be a winning dish.
No bloody better. If I see full plates, I think I'll just crawl under the table.
Well, we'll look forward to that. Here it is, seafood millefeuille with anchovy sand and oyster mayonnaise.
So who did what in the kitchen then?
Well, you de-shelled everything. Yeah. You sorted the oysters. Yeah.
Racking my brain trying to think, did I do anything else?
Well, let's have a think. Oh, yes, you did what you were told.
I think the start was extremely professionally done. I thought, oh, my God, this is a different league.
I absolutely loved the starter. So much effort went into that. The presentation was awesome. It was brilliant. I loved it. Absolutely loved it.
We found a treasure trove. An absolute treasure trove, wasn't it?
Yeah, just all old British coins, really. I find them all fascinating. Just think how many hands they must have passed through over the hundreds of years that they've gone through.
That put me off thinking of them like...
If I had a collection of coins, I would have them on display.
Why are they not? Why are they not out?
On the wall? On the wall? I've got a load of dirty coins.
I've got them in little boxes on the wall, like a little museum.
A lovely display case. Mm.
Absolutely.
Get the feeling you're outnumbered, Natasha.
Display case.
I think they'd look lovely in a study.
No, I just look ridiculous. Who hangs coins on the wall? You're 30-odd years old. You can't put coins on the bloody wall.
Why not? They're fascinating.
You can learn the order of the kings and queens.
No, I just know.
I'm fascinated by kings and queens. That's
you can learn about his coins, it's okay.
If I'm not allowed to have certain things, I'm hoping that my partner would compromise with me also and be...
Yeah, but to be fair, if he had a coin collection, that would not be out. No offence.
Ah, the art of compromise.
Everyone finished?
Yes, that was fantastic. Oh,
good, good.
With the starter going down a storm, time to move on to the main.
That one looks a bit more. It's those two.
Where are you going?
I don't know which one you're
going to. Dancing. If they don't like it, then we've tried our best and, you know, then clearly they've got no taste.
Beef Wellington, thin carrots and a couple of mushrooms drizzled in a red wine jus.
That's delicious.
Do you like it?
Really nice.
I was really impressed by the main. I only had one issue. My Wellington's fallen apart a bit.
It was a little bit overcooked for me, the beef.
I'm going to take issue with you there, dear, because I thought it was perfect.
Splendid, old boy, splendid! As it's the final night, Eveline's keen to pass on some pearls of wisdom.
Natasha, I would suggest I've got the work-life balance about right now. I like the time in the evenings to do things together. I make a rule, after 7 o'clock, I'm not going to check my emails. He doesn't like it anyway, gets annoyed with me.
Oh, see, I'm a bit sneaky. I go to the toilet.
Paul, a question for you then. Whenever she's working, do you feel neglected?
The only thing I think I'd change is taking phone calls out of the room in the evening so I don't have to listen to work calls all evening that I don't want to hear.
Michael would hate it if I took a work call in the living room. He'd go absolutely mad.
Oh, that's not allowed.
Is it not?
It's not allowed.
Really?
No. I don't know if she'll take it on board, but she was listening.
With the work issue tackled, Leanne has some advice for Paul.
So, Paul, I think maybe you should do some more romantic gestures. Like, definitely do something that would absolutely surprise Tash, because I think she would really appreciate it, and I think you will reap the benefits on that one.
Yeah, it can be a small surprise. It doesn't have to involve any money at all.
Most of our surprises cost very little indeed.
I have to put my oar in and actually say that it must be difficult for somebody to make plans for somebody when they're distracted all the time and working quite hard.
Oh, I can rearrange work, it's fine. For romantic gestures to Venice, might be... Anyway, to be fair, there's wireless in every hotel I've been in around the world. I can work from anywhere in
You're
the world.
You're a shocker. I'll certainly make more of an effort going forward on things like that.
I look forward to that.
Yeah. Oh, that's brilliant.
That's nice.
That's brilliant.
What's going to be the first romantic gesture?
Well, I can't tell you or it wouldn't be a surprise.
Okay, when's it going to be and roughly what time and what clothes do I need?
Is it so you can work it around work? Yeah.
Paul was very into more romantic gestures. Surprises are the key,
romantic
aren't they?
Surprises, as long as Natasha doesn't have to build it into her schedule.
Have we learned anything?
I think I've learned possibly that I should be more romantic. I'll certainly try to be.
Oh!
OK.
I'm still waiting for a comment.
Well, I don't know what to say, really. If you're expecting me to say I'm going to work less, I'm not.
Oh, well, at least he tried. Let's hope dessert's more successful.
No, don't pull that out. Go all the way. You might be...
Crikey, that should do it. We got there in the end. Here it is. Dark chocolate and orange tart with a couple of jellied worms.
Dark chocolate and orange go so well together, doesn't it?
Yeah, I think so. Definitely.
Oh, the dessert was just divine.
Divine. Slight practical problem of breaking that biscuit. That was a...
We needed another fork, another implement to break it with.
It just didn't do it for me, unfortunately. It was too bitter. It was too bitter for me.
And from bitter desserts to sour impressions.
Turn the heating down, because if you're cold, just put another layer of clothing on. What's the point?
I think it's just generally along the lines of, Paul! Paul! Paul, stop doing that. Go and do that, Paul. I think mine was fairly accurate. I wouldn't say I hear it every day. It's more like every
20 minutes. Because you're at work.
Every 20 minutes or so, rather than every day.
You're not here every 20 minutes.
I've never done an Eveline. Wait a minute, what are you thinking?
I can't do me.
I can't do you. I can't.
Finally stumped! And on that note, scores, please.
The food was slightly better tonight, but the atmosphere wasn't quite as fun as last night, so for that reason, we're going to give it a 16.
I'd probably score us 14.
Are you having a laugh?
Well, they'll need 16 or more to bag the grand.
We thought the food was really good, but it wasn't without its flaws, which is why we're giving it...
Whoa there! All the scoring's been done in secret, so it's down to the host to reveal the winner.
This is it, guys!
Everyone ready?
Oh, God!
Whoa! Yeah, money!
Wow!
I'm really nervous, I don't know why.
In third place, Evelyn and Michael.
Leanne, Ricky, it's between us and you.
Joint first!
Oh, that's a
Leanne and Ricky scored Natasha and Paul a 15.
And we're pleased that they both won because they both deserve to win.
No, guys get hot.
Okay.
My maths is really bad. High standards of food and presentation this week, so joint first. It's fair.
For more on Come Dine With Me, head to the Channel 4 website.
Brilliant.
Money's going on the lawnmower. Only joking. I'm going to surprise you with it.
Yeah?
We'll see.
He might throw in a strimmer as well. Mr. Bombastic!
Why does tonic water glow under ultraviolet light? Just one of the questions to be answered in tonight's Food Unwrapped at 8:30. And after that, on More 4, top chefs get a grilling from an audience of foodies. Cook's questions at 9. But next up, Simpsons. She called me Mr. Bombastic, tell me fantastic.